Hey guys, Avery Cry here, production lead here at Buell Motorcycles. We're at the end of the production line right now, and we wanted to give you guys an inside look at how our engines are assembled. All right, this is the start of the engine line right here. These two stations will cover the left and right crankcases. We'll be installing the bearings for both the transmission and the crankshaft. After that's completed, it'll move to the next station. Now that both the crankcase halves are completed, we're on to the next segment. This next part of the engine build is where the transmission and crankshaft will get installed into the crankcase. The transmission is installed with the shift forks and the shift drum. After both the transmission and crankshaft are installed, it moves down to the next station. The next station, we'll be bringing the two crank halves into one crankcase assembly. Gasket gets installed, and then we slide the crankcase over both the transmission shaft and the crankshaft, and then it'll be seated together with roughly 30 bolts. All right, so we just hopped off the production line. We have a sub-assembly area that feeds directly into it. This sub-assembly area produces about 8 different sub-assemblies that will be installed on the engine later on. We are assembling the cam towers for both the front and rear cylinder, along with the front and rear cylinder heads. So after the subcomponents are done for the cylinder head and cam towers, we'll go back onto the line where we do the rear end and front end buildup. This consists of the cylinder, cylinder head, and cam tower. This station is also where the valve lash is originally set and then handed off to the timing station for critical checks and potential valve adjustments. All right, now that the engine is timed, we're gonna hop back to our sub-assembly area where we make the rest of the casings for the rest of the engine. Over here, we're making our stator cover assembly. This station will also include our inner clutch cover, and clutch diaphragm cover that will be installed later on. So now that the sub-assemblies are done for the last half of the line, we're gonna build the engine horizontally. We already completed timing and built the engine up vertically, and now we're gonna do the clutch cover, stator cover, and follow that through until the spin test. This is the very final station of the engine line here. This station, we're installing the valve covers, followed up by a compression test. After the compression test is done, the engine will be lifted off of the engine stand, put onto a chassis cart, and then a bike is built around it.